Hey guys, it's the Dragon Critic, and today we're going to be doing another Battle of Films episode. It's been a long time since I've done this, and yeah, let's continue the series. Now, I know I said I was going to do my next episode on Ninjago versus Skylanders Academy. I will do that for the next episode, but I decided to actually do this one as the next episode instead. So, I will eventually do Skylanders Academy versus Ninjago at the next episode. Stay tuned for that this week. But today, I am going to be doing Kung Fu Panda 2 versus Kubo and the Two Strings. Yes, I know, you're obviously going to go,
yeah, but Dragon Critic, you always have to do your Kung Fu Panda versus Kubo or Hazatuanya Dragon.
Well, guys, can I just say, I love Kung Fu Panda, I love Kubo, and I love How to Train Your Dragon. Both of which, all three of them are in a tie as my favorite movie of all time. Well, mostly the sequels to Kung Fu Panda and How to Train Your Dragon. But hey, let's just continue this anyway. Also, by the way, I want to say my next episode after this will be The Wild versus Madagascar. So, Ninjago vs. Skylanders Academy will be after that episode. Alright, let's begin. So, in Kung Fu Panda 2, Po and the Five are now like, you know, everything is peaceful, they're all becoming great warriors and everything. But however, Lord Shen, a peacock, is now defeating all the masters across the land, and so he's like defeating everyone. Now Po and the Five must stop him. However, Po is getting these flashbacks of symbols from Shen, and are getting these mystical flashes about his childhood, and I mean, it's really dark for a kid's movie. In fact, wait a minute, this is a family movie. Oh my god! Kung Fu Panda 2 is by far, is amazing. Let's talk about Kubo. Kubo and the Two Strings follows a young boy named Kubo, whose father used to be a mystical samurai warrior. He's dead. But you'd have to see the movie, because I'm not going to talk about the spoilers. But however, Kubo did a huge mistake, and now his mother used the rest of her magic to save Kubo, and now Kubo teams up with a monkey named Monkey. It kind of reminds you of Kung Fu Panda! And then, teams up with a beetle named Beetle. All three of them team up, as Kubo must find the three pieces of the armor called the Sword, Unbreakable, Impenetrable Bubble, Helmet of Brass. I forget the name of that weapon. Alright, as he must find the armor and defeat the Threaded Moon King. Oh, this is gonna be good for villains. Now, let's be honest, the story in Kung Fu Panda 2 is way better. And here's the thing, Kung Fu Panda 2 continues the story and does exactly what a sequel should do. It continues it. It knows on what to do. It's darker. It's deeper. It's emotional. It's sad. It's scary. It's violent. It does everything what a sequel needs to do. While Kubo is definitely the same here, but Kung Fu Panda 2, I don't know, just is a bit, well, darker, a bit more fun, a bit more exciting and everything. While Kubo is still great and still fun and still probably my favorite movie as a tie. However, the story is going to go to Kung Fu Panda 2. The animation. Okay, this is going to be a tough one. I think Kubo has a bit better animation. Just kidding, they both have good animation. It's really hard to compare stop motion to computer animation. Well, Kubo does look a lot like Ninjago and, well, Kung Fu Panda. So I'd say the animation is going for a tie. The music. Okay, I'm gonna be completely honest. Kung Fu Panda 2 soundtrack is probably the best soundtrack I've ever heard in any beeping movie. Right? I love the soundtrack in this film. But this is definitely in a tie with the third film soundtrack as my favorite soundtrack. However, Kubo's got some really awesome soundtrack as well, don't get me wrong, but I think Panda 2 definitely has better music. The characters. Alright, in the second film, Poe is now well developed. Everything is now, he's all taking it to the next level. He's learning more about how to become a dragon warrior. He's learning, he's doing all this stuff, he's learning about facts and everything. And as he learns inner peace, also I forgot to mention in the second film, he does have to master inner peace. And it works. Poe does a great job doing inner peace. He does fantastic at the end of the film, which I'm not going to spoil. But trust me, the way his character, he's built up really, really dark. In the first movie, he was just this lovable character. In the second film, he is done fantastic. There's even scenes when he's all angry and everything. Kind of like in the third film, which I will talk about in my little spoilers review for that film, but I'm not going to tell you that scene in the third film in case you've never seen the third movie. But if you've seen the movie, you know what I mean when he gets angry. Alright, all the Furious Five, they're all great. Tigress is definitely, and I hope they do a love triangle between her and Poe. It needs to happen. On to Kubo, there's Monkey, who is like the side character. Mate, she is freaking sick, right? She is incredible in this film. Beetle is even funnier. He's like that comedic guy, but he is really good. Hell, Kubo himself is probably the best character. He acts like a kid. He knows how it feels. You get the sense of feeling in his character. You have fun with him. Now here's the thing I really wanted to talk about, are the villain, Lord Shen and the Moon King. I'm gonna be honest, the Moon King, I know you're gonna disagree, but the Moon King would looks like Shen, but as a person, as a human. I can definitely imagine Shen as the Moon King as a human. I can image that, I just see it. But Lord Shen is better. Lord Shen in the second Kung Fu Panda is amazing. He's violent. He did everything. He killed off Po's family. He killed off all the pandas. And I know I am talking about spoilers, but I'm really sorry. But by God, Kung Fu Panda 2 is amazing. The winner. Okay, now I know you're gonna disagree with me. But it's really hard to pick a winner. Both are amazing movies. Both are really dark, really great, and awesome tacular movies. These movies are amazing tacular. These movies are definitely getting 10s out of 10s. They're just incredible. What do you think is better? Do you think Kung Fu Panda 2 is better? Explain why. Do you think Kubo and the Two Strings is better? Explain why. Please like, give this a thumbs up, share the video with your friends, comment, and most importantly, please subscribe to my channel, because you'll love it. But I think it's really hard. As for a winner, maybe Kung Fu Panda 2. I'll have to think about that now. Anyways, I'll see you guys next time for my spoiler review of the third film. See you guys next time. Skadoosh.